In this New World's Weapon video, we're going to be covering the Rapier. This is a dexterity intelligence scaling weapon. It scales far more with dexterity than intelligence, but it can be used with either of these stats. And it's a really high skill floor weapon, in my opinion, meaning that if you're really good with this weapon, then you can be very, very good at this game, particularly in PvP. This weapon does sort of a four-hit combo. It does sort of a thrust and then kind of like a slash-slash and then another thrust. All these attacks deal thrust damage, even though the middle ones look like slashes, and all the attacks in this class or this weapon actually do thrust damage. So there are no abilities here that deal slash damage. This is a thrust damage only weapon. Figuring out this combo and using it effectively is a huge part of playing the Rapier build, because the two hits in the middle have very, very short range, like almost hatchet-like range, meaning you need to be right up against the enemy in order to hit with all of these attacks. And you want to hit with these attacks because some of them passives increase the damage of them, and others make it so that you reduce cooldowns when you hit with these attacks. So positioning, being able to pull off this combo in between abilities, is key to success with the Rapier. Ideally, what you want to do is you want to use an ability, pull off the combo, use an ability, or pull off the combo, use an ability, pull off the combo. You can break out of these in a pinch, obviously, if things are going badly with other abilities, and you definitely should. A big part of the Rapier play is reactive. Trying to figure out scenarios where you don't have to do that, or recognizing scenarios when you need to move and then continue with your combos, is how you're going to play the Rapier. Looking over the skill tree on the left there is the blood skill tree. No surprise here, this skill tree is all about bleeds, doing bleed damage, consuming bleeds to deal instant damage, and extending bleeds. So if you are into damage over time, like maybe you're fighting a hard-to-kill enemy like a boss, or maybe an elite monster, or maybe another player, this is a great way to keep sustained pressure on them. The first ability here is called Tondo, and this sets a bleed in front of you on anything that's standing in front of you. That's going to deal damage over time, as well as deal some initial damage as well. It has a pretty nice hitbox. It's not hard to land. A lot of the Rapier's attacks are like very thrusty, meaning they have narrower hitboxes than something that slashes from side to side. This is a very easy ability to land, and it's definitely one worth considering opening with to get that bleed going right away. The Flourish and Finish ability is really interesting because it does sort of a quick horizontal slash that still deals thrust damage, has a much larger hitbox, so this can hit multiple enemies, knocks things back, and then you can quickly hit left click on the mouse and lunge forward and hit the target. It also consumes any bleeds on the target, dealing damage, which is making it a very high damaging ability if you have lots of bleeds on your target. And even the capstone of this increases the damage that it consumes from these bleeds. It's a very good ability. It's sometimes hard to hit or connect with the follow-up attack because, again, it's a thrust attack with a small pointy weapon. So if anything is off a little bit left or the right, depending on what your ping is, sometimes you'll miss the follow-up, which can be disappointing. You want to use that ability, though, once you have one or two bleeds on your target in order to get the most out of it. Flurry is an interesting ability because it hits rapidly with five hits that do more than normal attacks, but they're fairly fast. It's still kind of a long channel ability, speaking-wise, because you do have to do five attacks in a row, making it sort of hard to land on like something that's moving at all. If it's like a boss that's sitting there on your tank, you can land it into its back very easily. Or if you open combat on an enemy who's not facing you and you crit five times in a row in its back, you can basically wipe it out with this one ability. I find situations where an enemy can't move is the best time to use these. So make sure you use these when appropriate and not always the second it's off cooldown. Moving along to the gray skill tree. This skill tree is all about skilled gameplay. Not only do you have a counterattack ability here, you have a dodge ability, as well as a mobility ability that can deal substantial damage and is good for gap closing as well as getting away from foes. So the first ability in the Grace Tree is called Riposte. This is a very high skill ability because it involves anticipating the attack of the enemies, which can be rather difficult if you're not familiar with the enemies that you're facing and the attacks that they deal, or if you're fighting a smart PvP player. However, what it allows you to do is basically prevent the damage from the attack and turn around and stun the opponent. And also, once you've got it upgraded, it makes you invulnerable for a few seconds and reduces the cooldowns of your other abilities. So this is an ability you want to use when you anticipate the attack of an enemy. This is pretty easy to do on most early game enemies. Most of them are pretty aggressive. You attack a couple times, pop this, flip it around on them, stun them, attack them a few times, Bob's your uncle, Fanny's your aunt, you're good to go. Doing it against a player is another matter. Some early, newbie players will just spam attacks and you can use it fairly easily. But maybe some more advanced players are not quite that noobish and they'll do other things. But figuring out when to use this ability and when not to use this ability is key. Moving along to the Evade skill, this is probably my favorite ability or second favorite ability in this weapon tree because it allows you to dodge just about any attack. It allows you to evade any direction you're moving. And it has a very, very short cooldown, doesn't use stamina. So if you combine this with the build that's very light, you can dodge, then use this, then dodge, then use this, makes you really, really hard to hit. And as you upgrade it, your light attacks actually reduce the cooldown of this. So you can use it even more frequently, meaning that you're going to become very hard to hit, and a very skilled player will use this very well. The trick of this is it's very hard to use the way that your keys are mapped by default, because you move with W, A, S, and D generally, unless you're using a controller or something, and you're going to have to press one of your, you know, buttons to fire this off, and that means you're going to have to remove one of your fingers from these buttons, making it very difficult to do it defaultly. So, and my recommendation is if you want to use this ability well, try and map it to something like on your mouse so that you can move a direction with your other hand and then dodge the direction that you want to move. It takes a little bit to get the hang of, and maybe you have to rebind your keys, but it'll be much, much more effective for you than just by using it default. The last ability here is Fletch. This is an amazing ability. You've probably seen it all over the place if you've seen any PvP footage, because it's excellent in PvP. Not only is it a fantastic gap closer to catch up to enemies, it's a good mobility skill getting through enemies to the other side of them if you're being chased by a lot of enemies. It's good for getting away. And if you kill a target with it, if you finish off an enemy, a player, or a regular NPC enemy, it resets the cooldown almost pretty fast. 80% of the cooldown time is reduced, meaning that, you know, it's just a few seconds and you can pop it again. So it makes a really good finisher. If you're fighting in combat, it has kind of a wide hitbox as well. So if you soften up some targets and then you fly through them with it, you can kill them all and reset that cooldown very fast, which is nice, and you can use it over and over again. The rapier pairs very well with any other dexterity scaling weapon or even intelligence-based weapon. A lot of people will go Ice Gauntlet and rapier in PvP to get some AoE from the Ice Gauntlet and some CC abilities in order with the mobility of the rapier. The rapier has excellent mobility. It has a lot of things that a lot of other weapons don't have. Probably the biggest downside is its range. It has very, very short range most of the time, meaning you got to get very, very close to targets, and if they have any sort of mobility whatsoever, which sometimes they do, not always, it can be very hard to deal damage. But other weapons you might want to pair it with are maybe a musket or a spear. A spear can actually help fill in that problem. It can allow you to fight at range when you're not close, and then if enemies close the gap and get up close to you, you can swap to your rapier and fight really close range and get a little dodgy with evade or whatever. And then you can swap back to the spear if they start trying to play a little bit off you a bit more. So there's definitely ways you can do that. Or you can use a ranged weapon, range down targets, and then, you know, close the gap on them with Fletch, and then get in melee range that way. So there's a lot of ways you can play with this weapon, but you're primarily going to want to play with either a dex-based weapon or some sort of intelligence-based weapon. A lot of people like to use the Ice Gauntlet, as I mentioned. That's primarily in PvP because they have a skill called Entombed that they can use to protect themselves and an AoE called Ice Storm. Usually what happens is they throw down Ice Storm, protect themselves in Entombed when they're outnumbered, pop out of it and start fighting into the players standing in their Ice Storm with the rapier, maybe teleport through them with Fletch or whatever, dash around, hit them a few times and try and finish them off and repeat that process. It works very, very well. Stay tuned for more weapon videos as we get into all 11 weapons in New World. And if you have other questions about these weapons or about the game in general, make sure you stop by the wiki, or you can drop by our Twitch channel and ask me directly. What weapons are you guys going to be using at the New World launch? What build are you going to be going for? Let us know in the comments below.